If you run a local business, ranking for the right keywords can mean the difference between attracting a steady flow of customers or getting lost in the search results. Local keyword research isn't just about finding high volume terms. It is about discovering the exact phrases your potential customers use when searching for businesses like yours in their area. So in this video, I'm going to share with you a couple of methods to do local keyword research. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, the first thing you need to understand is that not all local keywords will lead to sales or store visits. There are different types of search intent for each local keyword. If you want your local business to rank higher and attract the right customers, you need to think like your audience. That means going beyond basic keyword research and truly understanding why people are searching for something. That's their search intent. So there are essentially four types of local search intent. We have the transactional search intent keywords where customers searching for this type of keywords are ready to take action, be it buying a product, visiting a store, or making a booking. Examples will be emergency plumber near me or same day flower delivery, Austin. The next type of search intent will be navigational, where people searching for the keyword already know about your brand and they just want to find information such as the address or direction of your store. And the other search intent you should really work on are the informational intent, where searchers are looking for information that could lead to a sale, like cheap alternative to dental implants or how much does the roof repair cost. And finally, we have commercial search intent, where searchers are almost ready to take action, but they're just weighing their choices, like best dentist in Miami, cheapest gym memberships Brooklyn, best Thai restaurants near me, or restaurant A versus restaurant B, which is better. If you have doubts as to which search intent category a keyword belongs to, feel free to visit any of your page or posts, click on the RankMath tab, and add your keyword here, such as best Thai restaurant near me. And as you hover towards the right of the keyword, you will see the show intent feature. Click on it, and it will tell you what search intent the keyword belongs to. If you want to find out more about the search intent feature, feel free to check out this video right here. Now that you understand the search intent of local keywords, let's work on finding the right keywords to target for your business. If you don't know where to get started with local keyword research, then start thinking about what your customers may be searching for to find your business. Let me give you some formulas. You can start with your product or service, plus near me, such as if you are a dentist, your customers may search for dentist near me. Or if you are in the pet grooming business, your customers may search for dog groomer near me. Near me local keywords work because according to Statista, 82% of smartphone users use near me searches to help them shop. So these type of keywords work well. The next formula you can use is your product or service plus the city or neighborhood your business is located, such as hair salon downtown Chicago or towing service South Austin. The trick is to target neighborhoods like Wicker Park or Brentwood, because neighborhood specific keywords have less competition than city only search terms. Next, we have best plus product or service plus location, such as best pizza in Brooklyn or best HVAC company Phoenix. These kinds of local keywords work because they have commercial intent and might likely turn into a sale. And then product or service plus specific need plus location, such as dentist for kids in San Diego or accountant for small business Austin. Location plus service plus price related terms, like affordable divorce lawyer Miami or Los Angeles brake pad replacement cost. Then problem plus solution plus location, such as leaking pipe emergency repair Houston or broken AC same day repair Phoenix. Season or event plus service plus location, like summer pool cleaning service Atlanta or tax season accountant Chicago. As you can see, there are so many different types of local keyword formulas you can use. If you have more than the ones that I've shared, do let us know in the comments down below. Anyway, you can further expand your local keyword list by using AI tools, such as if you are a RankMath user, you can visit the Content AI module and click on the chat tab. From here, you can chat with our RankBot, which is trained to perform SEO tasks. Now imagine I run a plumbing business in Singapore. You can write a prompt such as, "Act as an experienced local SEO specialist. I own a plumbing service business." You can swap this with the business you are in. then located in Singapore or your city or neighborhood. Create a comprehensive list of 30 to 50 local keywords with informational, transactional, and commercial search intent that potential customers might use to find my business. And as you hit enter or return, give it a couple of seconds, and it will provide you with a list of local keywords your business can target. Now, once you have found your list of local keywords, you want to further research them to know if there are search volumes. More about that later. Now, we want to focus on gathering more local keywords. One of the best local keyword research tools is the Google Keyword Planner. And if you have not used the tool before, I highly recommend that you watch this video right here to get everything set up. The tool is free, by the way. So we are in the Google Keyword Planner too. And what you want to do is to click on the Discover New Keywords option. And then let's say that you own a hair salon in Austin, Texas. You will first add your product or service, such as hair salon. And if this is not the location where your business resides, you can click on it, remove this, and change it to the city or country it is located, and hit save. And then as you hit get results, you will see a whole list of local keywords that relate to your business. You can always adjust this seed keyword with those you have formulated earlier, and you will have many unique local keyword suggestions. You can also add more related keywords the tool has suggested. As you can see, currently there are about 1300 keyword ideas based on the broad seed keyword. And if we add hairdresser and hit get results, the number of keywords expanded exponentially. Add another keyword and the number of keywords expanded further. And if you click on this column, you can sort the keywords based on the most number of searches to the least. And this can help you prioritize which keywords are more important. And if you think this is difficult to analyze because there are thousands of keywords, you can view the keywords in clusters or groups. You can click on this and select group view. Give it a while for it to process. And here you can target keyword groups instead. For example, if you expand this group, you can see that these keywords are similar. And if you have a service page that targets one or a few of these keywords, there is a high chance that the service page will rank for all these keywords. That's the beauty of seeing keywords in the group view. Other than Google Keyword Planner, you can use Google Trends to find local keywords. All right, we are in Google Trends. What we want to do is to click on the Explore option. And then let's use the same business example. We will add hair salon as the search term. And select the place where your business resides. We want to know the trending searches for the past 12 months. But of course, you can adjust this time frame to suit your need. And then let's choose web search, because local searches mainly come from it. And as we scroll to the bottom, we will see some related queries. These are rising queries, which means over the past 12 months or whatever period you have specified, these keywords are rising in popularity. I would presume if you are in the business, you will probably know some of these competitors, but I would say local keywords are something like this or this. And you can also switch this to top, which means top trending keywords over the period you have selected. From here, you can definitely find local keywords that your customers are searching for. Now, there is one more local keyword research tool I would like to share with you, which is the free keyword tool by WordStream. This is the tool I'm talking about, and this is the link. You simply need to add a keyword here, let's say hair salon again. And then you want to select the location, say Texas, and hit continue. And in a while, it will provide you with a list of local keywords. This tool is perfect for you to check if there is any search volume for the keyword as well. You can simply add the exact keyword and select the location, and it will tell you if there is any search volume for the keyword. Simple as that. So with these tools, you will never run out of local keywords for your business to target. But if you want more, here's more. Forums and local directories are one of the best places to figure out what your customers are asking in their own words and what they are searching for. For example, since Reddit is one of the most authentic sources of unfiltered customer conversations, you can uncover local keywords that traditional tools miss. You could go to Google and search for site:reddit.com and then your local keywords such as best pizza in Boston. From here, you will find topics started by others on Reddit related to your query. Going through the meta titles, you will find some very interesting local keywords, like traditional Italian pizza in Boston. And then let's go to the second page,
We can see best pizza in the North End, and then good pizza places in Boston. Go to the next page, let's scroll down. We will see best pizza in South Boston. And if you go deeper, we can see bar pizza in Boston proper, best pizza off Mass Pike, and so many unique local keywords. Look for emotional triggers in those keywords, such as on the first page, people are looking for traditional. And also, you want to look out for unique location references, such as on page 3, there is someone looking for pizza places in South Boston instead of just Boston. So all these emotional triggers and location references can make up a goldmine of local keywords for your business.
Other than the search results of Reddit, you can leverage on customer comments on Yelp.
For example, I will search for local keywords like HVAC repair Dallas, and then I will take note of the top organic competitors ranking on the local pack. In this case, it is Rescue Air and Plumbing, Service Experts Heating, and Dallas Heating and Air Conditioning. And then I will do another search to look for their Yelp profile, and here it is. Now, when I visit a Yelp profile, I would scroll below. You will see a section where it says services offered. These can be added as part of your local keywords if you just add the location behind them. And then you scroll down further and you will see a section where it says people also search for. These are the top keywords people use to find this business. So you can take note of them and probably use it for your business. And then I will look at its reviews, focusing on the 5-star reviews. You want to read through the reviews and look for unique keywords. Such as we know customers would appreciate a knowledgeable, then technician. So these two keywords could make up knowledgeable HVAC technician in Dallas. And then in the next review, we are lucky to see so many important terms, such as same day, speedy, and reliable. As we scroll down further, we can see professional and knowledgeable again. So as you scroll through and read the reviews, I'm pretty sure you will find unique terms that can make up local keywords for your business.
Believe it or not, finding local keywords through your competitor's sites is one of the most effective local keyword research methods.
For example, let's search for a local keyword such as best electrician in Austin. Take note of the top competitors in the local pack. Let's use Mr. Electric of Austin as an example. Let's say that this is your competitor's site. You want to copy its domain and paste it here. If the company serves different areas, they may have the city or state in the URL. So you want to make sure to copy the URL path with the location. And then you want to remove the protocol, and right in front of the URL, you want to type site colon and hit enter or return. And now focus on the meta title of your competitor pages. Most of the time, you will see your competitor pages optimized with local keywords, such as electric repair service in Austin, home backup generator installation service in Austin, and so many other local keywords in this example. From here, you can probably create service pages targeting these local keywords.
If you don't know how to create service pages and optimize them for local SEO, I highly recommend that you check out this video right here. It's a long video, but it covers everything about local SEO. Feel free to check it out. The link is in the description. Now, assuming that you have decided to create a service page targeting a local keyword, and you want to know if the page should target other supporting keywords, what you want to do is to go to Google and search for the keyword you are targeting. Let's say that it is Emergency Plumber NYC. And then you will go to the People Also Ask section. And immediately you can see what other questions users are concerned about when searching for the local keyword. They are concerned about the cost per hour, as well as how much to tip the plumber. And if you expand one of the questions, you will see further related queries that should be included in your service page. As you click on more queries, more will appear. The key is to pick out queries or concerns you want to address in your service pages. That way, your page will have a higher chance of ranking for the local keyword. Now, if you have not set up your Google Business profile, you are missing out a lot as a local business owner. And if you need help setting it up, I highly recommend that you check out this video right here, as I will walk you through step by step on how to set it up. The link is in the description.
Anyway, if you have your Google Business profile set up, you can click on performance. And as you scroll down, you will see something like this where they will show you what your business is ranking for. And if you click on see more, it will show you more local keywords.
If you find local keywords that are important to you, such as they are bringing in sales, but you're not getting a lot of impressions on them, you want to put more focus on optimizing those local keywords on your pages. So these are the methods to do local keyword research. Once you have a list of local keywords, you want to use tools like WordStream's Keyword 2 to identify its search volume. And if there is search volume, you want to optimize your site and business profile with those keywords. Now, if you have any unique methods to do local keyword research I have not covered, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And if this video helped, please do us a favor and smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.